Welcome to Paintable Tips and Tricks, guys. This video is going to show you how to blend color with this soft brush. And to demonstrate that, I'm going to use this painting of mine. It's a portrait which has every values, every shadow, every highlight in a geometric shape, and nothing is blended. Personally, I don't start my painting like that, but that way it's going to be easier for me to demonstrate the tricks and the tips in this video. So hi guys, so the first tip is going to be to blend color with a soft round brush. And what I mean by soft round brush is the brush that I have right now. And as you can see, when I paint with it, it will automatically create a soft edge, which automatically then will blend the color with the background and the foreground color that I'm applying. To give you an example with another color, I could take another color here, and by painting it in the middle, the two colors will blend together automatically, which will save me time to actually create new tones. I would like to show you that on an actual illustration here that I prepared. It's an illustration that I prepared with really quick patches to represent different values of it. So as you can see, there's nothing blended right now. And I want to show you how to blend this now with the soft brush. So I'm going to create a new layer on top of it. And by just selecting the colors and start painting and blending them, I can pick up the new tones that I'm creating and just start applying them everywhere. As you can see, they're going to start mixing together. By repeating this, I'll be able to finishing all of this everywhere. Now, if I have to point out the pros and cons of this technique, I would say that as a pros, the fact that it creates an automatic gradient is definitely a plus. That way, it's helping me mixing the two colors that I'm blending all the time, and I don't have to worry if it's going to make lines or anything. It's just going to blend them together really perfectly. If I had to point back to the cons of this technique, is it could get really muddy if I'm not really careful. And let me give you an example of what I mean. If I were to use a really small brush and try to blend it, all the parts would just start to be really, really muddy. As you can see right now, it's kind of not blending all together. It's patchy at some places. And that's basically because my brush is too small. If I'm going the other side here and I'm choosing a bigger brush, I can easily now blend the big portions of the portrait and moving up slowly the pigments. Obviously, if I'm using a bigger brush, I cannot go in the corner of her eye here. I will have to use a smaller brush and just be more careful. But if I'm doing something like the whole cheek, then using a bigger brush will actually help me making sure that I'm not getting too muddy. So as you can see here, it's having a really nice transition between the cheekbone and the jaw, and here it's more muddy and patchy. And that's it for this tip. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you're interested in trying this technique and using the same brushes that I'm using, just click on the link below the video.